proud to be exposed to encouragement that becomes contagious. Welcome to Keep the Faith. I'm Donna Cruz.
And I'm Keith Stevens. There's no substitute for you. The real you. The you God created. There's a lot of pressure these days to be lots of things. But as you listen to this hour of Keep the Faith, you'll hear songs and stories to help you be yourself, live out your beliefs, and show respect for others along the way.
I found myself lost in who I was, always stretching or compressing myself to, well, what I thought others expected of me. I was playing a song with my life that wasn't actually my song.
What they said wasn't true. You're beautiful. Sticks and stones break your bones. I know what you're feeling. Words like those won't steal your glow. You're one in a million.
You know, I, for a long time, felt like I was supposed to be raising perfect children. And God really showed me that, no, that wasn't at all, that I'm to raise purposed children. My job as a mom is to help my children understand that God has imbued them with very specific gifts, with different twists and turns to their personalities, with different focuses and interests. And He does all of this because He has intent and purpose for them.
Building a healthy affect that revolves around three keys, and that's identity, knowing who you are at your core, its significance, knowing the greatness that you were created for and created with, the unique abilities and talents, and then its perspective, the lens through which you look at life.
You don't have to feel like a wasted space. Your original cannot be replaced. If you only knew what the future holds after a
when you have a healthy I factor, then regardless of the external pressures, you can navigate through them well and avoid self-sabotage and really just short-circuiting the life that you were called to live.
Bart Millard from Mercy Me shares how he found out who he truly is, and it has to do with someone else. That's next on Keep the Faith.
I keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. Ooh, oh, you say I'm loved when I can't feel a thing. You say I'm strong when I think I'm weak. And you say I'm held when I am falling short. Don't belong. Oh, you say I am yours. You'll have every failure, God. You'll have every victory.
Songs and stories to celebrate the true you. This is Keep the Faith.
White lies and desperation, hard times and conversations. No one should ever love me like you do. Sometimes my bad decisions define my false suspicions. No one should ever love me like you do. While I'm on this road, you take my hand somehow. You really love who I really am. I push you away. Confidence was shaking. My wounds and my past was saying no one should ever love me like you do. While I'm on this road, you take my hand somehow. You really love who I really am. I push you away till you won't.
Faith.
I'm Keith Stevens. Being the real you? Well, it starts with understanding what's up to you and what isn't. Because if you are the hero in your story, that can be mentally, physically, and emotionally exhausting. Bart Millard of Mercy Me was living in that place.
I know you're able and I know you can. Save through the fire.
says things start to change when you realize it's not up to you.
We got to a point to where we just had a lot of tragedy in my life personally. You know, loved ones that passed away. My oldest son diagnosed with diabetes when he was 2. Just all these things that happened to where, you know, we weren't dealing with any of it, to where it took a really big strain on our marriage. And I went through this huge depression to where, like, I'd be home, my kids would be climbing on me, and I wouldn't even know that they're there. And so my wife kind of tricked me into going to see a counselor, and just she started going and then had me come to kind of see how she was doing. And all of a sudden she's slipping out of the room like, wait a minute, this is about me, hold on. But had this amazing godly woman that was one of the first people to kind of show me, you're not going to make it better. You're not capable. And good news is, you're not going to make it worse. Everybody's always told me there's more work to be done, and so I was almost offended. And so it took years to unpack just this understanding of who I am in Christ. But what's crazy is I thought that I was quitting the band at that point. I thought that was my, hey, quit working, you're out. And at the time I wanted to, because I was tired of playing by the rules and trying to jump through so many hoops and spin so many plates. But what's crazy is once you start understanding who you are in Christ, and that all of this is kind of the sloppy seconds of a healthy relationship with Christ, I started falling in love with music again. It became just an overflow.
There's got to be more than going back and forth, from doing right to doing wrong, because we were taught that's who we are. Well, come on, get in line right behind me, you along with everybody, thinking there's worth in what you do. Then like a hero who takes the stage when we're on the edge of our seat, saying it's too late. Well, let me introduce you to amazing grace. No matter the bumps, no matter the bruises, no matter the scars, still the truth is a cross has made. The cross has made you flawless. Like this, and wrap him up in righteousness. But that's exactly what he did. No matter the bumps, no matter the bruises, no matter the scars, still the truth is a cross has made. The cross has made you flawless.
You have been born an original. Don't die a copy. An original means something that has been designed by the artist, that has been created only for that particular person or thing. Somebody is waiting for the version of you.
You're beautiful. You're beautiful.
This is Keep the Faith.
Megan Alexander was in a tough spot when she was asked to model a dress on Inside Edition. But next on Keep the Faith, she shares how the right response can be a win for everyone.
Flipping through a magazine, says she wants to look that way. But her hair isn't straight, her body isn't fake, and she's always felt overweight. Well, little girl 14, I wish that you could see the beauty is within your heart. And you were made with such care, your skin, your body, and your hair are perfect just the way they are. There can never be a more beautiful you. It's not too late, you can be saved. If you feel depressed with past regrets, the shameful nights, hope to forget, can disappear, they can all be washed away. By the one who's strong, can right your wrongs, can rid your fears, dry all your tears, and change the way you look at this big world.
To drag anyone down, to lift yourself up. As you listen to Keep the Faith, you'll hear songs and stories filled with encouragement and hope.
Scared. Oh, I thought I knew scared. But I'm so filled with fear. I can barely move. Doubt. I've had my share of doubt, but never more than right now. I'm wondering, where are you? Here on the edge of fall apart. Somehow your promises find my trust. This is the truth I'm standing on. Even when all my strength is gone, you are.
Keep the faith.
I'm Donna Cruz. When you understand who you truly are, you can live out what you believe without shame. But let's face it, in today's world, that can be hard, but not impossible. Megan Alexander is a national correspondent for Inside Edition. She shares some of the things she's learned in her book, Faith in the Spotlight.
So it was a couple of years ago, a popular reality star had walked the red carpet in this dress. And on my television show, we often model the dresses the day after and offer a less expensive option or version to our viewers. And I was encouraged to wear that dress. And I just took one look at it. I just wasn't comfortable. It's not my style. And I just said, I'd rather not. And I did get some pushback from the stylist. And I said, no, but then I offered a plan B. So I said, hey, there's another star that wore this black dress that I think I could pull off. Went and got it. I said, I know we can make this happen, guys. And I put it together. And then they said, okay, sounds good. We'll go with that. And we'll put that white dress on someone else. So I want to encourage people to work the problem. I don't really believe you can always just say no and stop the train. Look, I'm there to do my job and to deliver for my boss. I'm also working with a lot of other people, and we're under deadline to deliver this show. So be creative. Be a part of the team in making these decisions, because then in the end, it can be a win-win for everyone.
This world has nothing for me. This life is not my own. I know you go before me, and I am not alone. This mountain rises higher, the way seems so unclear. But I know that you go with me, so I will never fear. I will trust in you. Whatever will come my way, through fire or pouring rain,
trust in you. We will not be moved. We will trust in you. Yeah, we won't be shaken. We will trust in you.
Can never truly be at your best unless you stay in your lane. And when you start comparing yourself with other people, it has that tendency to take you out of your lane. Listen, there's something that God's called you to do and you to do only. So stay in your lane.
Fix my eyes on you. Oh, 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 on you.
This is Keep the Faith.
Next on Keep the Faith, Kathy Lee Gifford opens up about her friendship with those who think differently, like comedian Craig Ferguson.
And Craig said to me, "Why do you love me and Ricky? We're not great guys. We're not good guys." And I said, "What are you talking about? You're great guys. Of course I love you. And God loves you." And he looked at me and said, "Kathy, we've never been told ever by somebody of faith that they love us."
Who am I that the highest king would welcome me? I was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Who the sun sets free, who is free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I. A slave to sin, Jesus died for me. Yes, he died for me. Who the sun sets free, who is free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my place for me, I'm a child.
Contagious Encouragement on Keep the Faith.
Whoa! You know, I woke up one morning, I'm like, how dare I? The boy's a dreamer. The world will give him some knocks, but he has such a positive attitude, he'll bounce through them. Who am I to just suddenly put all this defeat on him? Why can't I say, Rocky, I believe in you. Rocky, you're going to do so great.
Hello, my name is Regret. I'm pretty sure we have met. Every single day of your life, I'm the whisper inside that won't let you forget.
So many of us in social media, we try to airbrush our image. But what I really believe the world is looking for is authenticity. Sometimes it's the faults, the flaws, the failures that really bring the greatest testimony.
People are shaming us or feeling shame for us and casting in our direction, and we have a choice there. That day in the truck, I made a new choice. I took a picture of myself laughing, a big hot mess with no AC, and I decided I wasn't going to borrow the shame. I was going to be grateful I had a vehicle. I turned around my mentality.
I am no longer defined by all the wreckage behind. The one who makes all new has proven it's true. So take a look at my life. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King.
Being myself and going after my dreams, just trying to knock down fear, trying to grow closer every day with Jesus, those are the things that people over and over again tell me inspire them and motivate them. And for the longest time, I was like, but I'm not doing anything. What are you talking about? I'm constantly surprised by what people are inspired by. Just me being confident in who I am and who I was made to be.
What love the Father has lavished upon us, that we should be called His children. I am a child of the One True King.
Just knowing that I'm fearfully and wonderfully made, there's no one else like me. No one can do me better than me, but just do you. I just think that's so important because God made you different. So be different.
Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. And Amazing Grace is the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King.
Comparison is the worst. It just really tears us down instead of building each other up. And God just wants each of us to paint our own lives, to be creative in that. He stretches out a canvas in front of us and hands us the brushes and the paint and says, you know, go create the most beautiful picture of my love.
You'll find more resources to help you be your authentic self at KeepTheFaith.com.
Maybe you're not like me. Maybe we don't agree. Maybe that doesn't mean we gotta be enemies. Maybe we just get brave, take a big leap of faith, call a truce so me and you can find a better way. Let's take some time, open our eyes, look and listen. Yeah. And we're gonna find we're more alike than we are different.
Drowning their voices.
pieces out, 'cause I believe that you and me can find some common ground. See, maybe I'm not like you, but I walk a mile in your shoes, if it means I might see the world the way you do. Let's take some time, open our eyes, look and listen, and we're gonna find we're more alike than we are different.
This is Keep the Faith.
Hey, I'm Keith Stevens. When you have a confidence and self-respect that comes from knowing your true, original self, it frees you up to love those who are different. Kathy Lee Gifford lives her life that way, and since leaving the Today Show, she's been staying really busy. She has a new book for kids called Hello, Little Dreamer, and wrote and starred in a movie called Then Came You with Craig Ferguson.
I have a lot of friends like Craig and like Ricky Gervais who don't believe in what I believe spiritually. That doesn't matter. I love them. And our common ground is our sacred ground. We need to understand that more than ever at this time in life. I love the story of Ruth Bader Ginsburg and Justice Scalia. Their friendship was extraordinary. They always put aside their own personal differences to honor the humanity in each other. I was going to tell you, one day we were on set with Then Came You, and Craig said to me, out of the blue, sort of, he goes, Kathy, why do you love me and Ricky? We're not great guys. We're not good guys. And I said, what are you talking about? You're great guys. Of course I love you. And God loves you. You're made in his image like I am. Why wouldn't I love you? I love who God loves. And he looked at me and said, Kathy, we've never been told ever by somebody of faith that they love us. You cannot hate someone and say you love God. They will know you are Christians by your love for one another. It says in the scripture, love one another as I have loved you. Jesus's whole life message was love the way the Father has loved me and brought me to love you, teach you how to love.
Hey, we really enjoyed visiting with Kathy Lee for our podcast called CIA, Contagious Influencers of America. It's a really personal conversation that will get you caught up with what God is doing in her life these days. And it's free wherever you get your podcasts or at KeepTheFaith.com.
Now, more than ever, people everywhere are looking for a miracle. As you listen to Keep the Faith this upcoming holiday season, you'll hear songs and stories of hope to remind you that you've not been forgotten. '20 has been heartbreaking, scary, confusing, and frustrating. And your holidays probably won't feel the same. But this Christmas, as you think about the greatest miracle ever given to anyone, you'll be inspired, once again, to believe.
Hi, I'm Sam on Keep the Faith with some contagious encouragement.
How cool is it that the same God who created mountains and oceans and galaxies looked at you and thought the world needed one of you too?
I'm not a warrior. I'm too afraid to lose. I feel unqualified for what you're calling me to. Alone with your strength, got no excuse. 'Cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense. So I can face my giants. Shepherd boy and made him a king. So I'm gonna trust you and give you everything. I'll be a conqueror 'cause you fight for me. I'll be a champion claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses. Shake the wall, won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the wall. Won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense. So I can face my giants with confidence.
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Keep the Faith's confidence coach, Trish Blackwell. It's amazing how different life becomes when you're not afraid to be yourself. If you've experienced that, we'd love to hear your story. Just call 800-726-4150. That's 800-726-4150.
My mother always told me that I would never amount to anything, that I want nothing but a piece of trash. It was drilled into my head from the time I was a little girl power. I never could understand why my mother never loved me. But I found a man who loved me. We were together from 1991 till he died in 2013. And I finally was able to look in the mirror and say, I am beautiful because God don't make trash. I rose above it and turned out to be a much better, stronger person. Because what she said wasn't going to destroy my life. If she had been right, I never would have found a man who loved me for me. God sent one of the most wonderful men into my life who helped me to grow and see myself in a different light. I am beautiful.
If fear is the thing holding you back from being who God created you to be, I'd love to have you take my Fear Detox Masterclass from my College of Confidence. I've teamed up with Keep the Faith to make it free. Just visit KeepTheFaith.com.
Mirror, mirror, mirror on the wall, telling those lies, pointing out your flaws. That isn't who you are. That isn't who you are.
Start again, give honor to the end, yeah, we can start.